welcome to the lesson time. It's going to be very exciting, not just for this week, but this year long. We're going to have some amazing, miraculous stories from the Old Testament of the Bible. We can learn about Abraham, Joseph, David, and many more people who will teach us some valuable and wise tips to live life in a beautiful way that pleases God. So please join in every week for this whole year and be blessed.
Hello children, welcome to the fifth week of your Sunday school by Way Bible School. Children, today our lesson's name is Manna's Water Sweetened. Manna's Water Sweetened. Manna means bitter. How the bitter water got sweetened? Who did that? Why he would do that is what we are going to learn today. Last week we have learned that God had parted the Red Sea, how Israel people walked across it, how Egyptian army drowned in it. We are going to learn what happened after that. After Israel people crossed the Red Sea, they celebrated the victory. They praised God, they thanked God, and then they started their journey again towards the promised land called Canaan. They entered 3 days of wilderness in the land of Shur. In the land of Shur. Wilderness means a place where you would not get water to drink, a place where you would not get food to eat. They searched, they wandered everywhere, they could not find water. Finally, they reached a place called Mara where they found water, but it was too bitter to drink. Can you drink bitter water? I cannot. No one can, right? Now, Israel people, they could have prayed to God, right? God, please grant us water to drink. Instead, they have complained. Moses, what are you doing? We are so thirsty. We do not have water to drink. Moses did not complain, children. Moses prayed to God. And then God told Moses what to do, and he had shown him a tree. Moses found the tree and he had cut it down and he had thrown that log into the water of Mara. Do you know what happened? The bitter water of Mara turned into sweet. All the people of Israel drank from it and they were satisfied. Children, then and there, the God has made a law saying, whoever listens to me, whoever obeys my commands, I will heal them, is what God said. What did God say? I am the Lord. I will heal the people who listens to me, who obeys my commands. And Israel people feared him and they obeyed his commands. Now children, I just want to ask you a question. Do you want to be the person who complains to the Lord, or do you want to be the person who would pray to God? Don't be a complainer, okay? Because God knows all your needs. Do you know what? After they crossed this place, they found 12 wells of fresh water, which means God definitely knew what their need was. But then they started to complain too early. Children, do not be like them, okay? You should wait. When you ask God, you should wait for the right time, because he knows when to give you. Also, he knows what to give you. He knows the best. Bible says, lay down all your worries, all your burdens at God. He will definitely take care of it. Now, when we talk about your parents, do not compare with other children and complain, Mama, I need that Barbie doll. Mama, I want that Superman dress. Children, you can ask them, but then don't complain, because definitely your parents will give you the best when they have time and when they have resources. You got to understand them, children. You have to thank them when they give you something. Similarly, when you receive something from God, thank them. Thank God. Okay? I'll show you something. Look, this is the bitter water of Mara. When Moses had thrown the tree into the water as instructed by God, the bitter water of Mara turned into sweet water. Similarly, If you have the bitter heart, maybe you were hurt, maybe you did not receive what you wanted from God very long time. If you are sad, God can definitely turn your bitter heart into better one, a happy one. Do you like it? You can make it one. You can make one for yourself too. All right, children. Before we do the activity sheet, if you decide never to complain to God, and if you decide to obey and to wait for God about all your needs, agree with me in this prayer. Close your eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to your presence. Master, we know that you definitely know all our needs. We completely trust that you would grant us our needs at your perfect time. Lord, help us to have patience, but help us not to complain. Lord, as we grow old, help us to be the people who would obey your commands. We love you, O Lord. In the Jesus' most precious name we pray. Amen. All right, children, open your activity sheets. You have them? Choose the correct answers, okay? The first question is, Israel people walked dash days as they moved into wilderness. 3 days of wilderness, okay? Second one, they walked into the wilderness of Shur. It's Shur. Third one, they reached a place called Mara. Mara means bitter. Fourth one, Israelites were thirsty and they started dancing. No, they started complaining. Fifth one, Moses prayed and God showed him a tree. When Moses threw the tree into water, the bitter water became salty? No, sweet. God made a law there that if they diligently hear and obey God's voice, then God would heal them. You have yes or no, correct or wrong. Okay, the first one, God is not concerned about our needs. No, it's a false. God is definitely concerned about all our needs. More than you and me know what our needs are, God knows our needs the best. Second one, we should complain when we don't get an answer to our prayer. No, children, we should not complain. Do you know what? In Bible, there was a person called Hannah. She prayed to God about not having a child, but she did not complain. Okay? We should not complain. Now, third one. Our Heavenly Father takes care of us about all our needs. Even if it is about drinking water or the air we breathe or even the single grain of rice, He knows our needs and He will take care of it. Okay? Fourth one, we always need to remember what God has done for us. Yes, we should always remember all the good things God has done for us, and we should praise and thank Him. Fifth one, God will turn our bitter experiences to sweet experiences. Yes, children, God definitely will turn all our bitter experiences, you know, our hurts, the humiliations, the bullying, if you come across, He will turn all of them into sweet experiences. Okay? Children, your memory verse is from Exodus 15th chapter 26th verse. Exodus 15th chapter 26th verse. For I am the Lord who heals you. For I am the Lord who heals you. Now children, learn it and send us your activity sheets. You have a coloring sheet. You can color it. Okay? Now, until next week, be blessed. Bye, children.
Hello children, hope you enjoyed the program today and hope to see you next Sunday along with your friends. Till then, Vadayan, which means bye-bye.